decided it was time to bust out the old Mosin. Who in the hell doesn't like doing a little Mosin shooting? Have a little fun here. Oh, buddy. Man, I love this old gun. Shooting the Mosin. Thought maybe you guys would like to see the target as we're putting rounds into it. The rounds that are not taped have been the first ones I shot with the Mosin, and hopefully you'll be able to see new holes being made. Yeehaw! I'm gonna go ahead and go grab the target, and I'm gonna replace it with a new one just so we can have some clean target. The old Mosin ain't shooting too bad today. Go ahead and take a look at this target. There's one here, one there, and then the rest of them are all right here. That's 15 rounds, 3 load-ups of the gun. You can see I taped on the back. Those other bullet holes aren't from the Mosin, they were from the 308. But that one did go through right there. So probably a vertical spread of, I don't know, 5 inches. Horizontal spread of 3. Not too bad, not too shabby for the old Mosin. Last time I brought it out shooting, it was doing somewhere between 4 to 5 MOA. Looks like it's shooting pretty good today. I went ahead and got us a new target up there. Went ahead and did 2 of them, one on the top and one on the bottom. And we'll go ahead and shoot it some more. See if we can get some better accuracy out of the old Mosin. And not only that, just have some fun shooting it. Because it is a blast to shoot. You're running surplus ammo, is super cheap. Be able to come out here and shoot all day for a little bit of nothing. I really enjoy it. So, all right, let's give her a try. All right, got her loaded back up again, and let's get some more shots downrange. Looking through my scope, that looks to be a pretty good group. Let me look at it through the camera here. Oh, it looks like one went low. I didn't see that through the scope. Yep, threw one low. That was probably me. Not looking too horrible. Getting this sucker pretty good and warm. Buddy, she is getting hot. Oh, you guys drifted off the target a little bit, didn't you? Not bad for a 1940s gun at 100 yards. With a 3-9 scope and me behind the trigger, that's a hell of a handicap just to have me behind the trigger. We're going to go ahead and let it cool down a little bit. Getting a little hot on the hand. And then we'll shoot her some more. All right, we let her cool down a little bit. I went ahead and removed the top wood off the top of the barrel. Pulled the bands off and pulled the top wood off just to let it cool a little quicker. Now I'm just gonna keep shooting at that top one. Give her a couple more loads full on that top one. And see if we can get it to settle down. Get it to it and me used to being shot again. And then after we get it settled down a little bit, maybe we'll go down to that bottom one and try and do one 5-round group, see how it looks on it. That felt pretty damn good. One more load up top and then we'll go to that lower target. Sweet smell of gunpowder. Woo! Love it. Alright, so let's go ahead and adjust you guys down to the bottom target. Now I'm gonna really take my time and just try and put 5 shots as accurate as I can on that bottom target. And we'll see how it turns out. Alright, there's our 5-round group. Don't know how well you can see it on the camera. I'll go ahead and run down and grab the target and we'll come back and look at it. Alright, I ran up and grabbed the target in the target stand, and this was our upper group we were shooting at first. That circle is about a 3-inch circle, hand drawn. Here's my hand for comparison. I have fairly large hands, but one, you know, couple farther outliers, but for the most part I'd say from here to here is maybe 8-inch. So 15 rounds, 20 rounds, however many this was, all within this distance. And then we'll go ahead and look at the bottom one. And I would just say right offhand, this was probably me. But it's what the group was. That's 5 rounds. That's what we shot. So that's what we shot. So I would say 4.5, 5-inch group, all included. These ones here, 2-inch maybe. 2-inch for 4 of them. And then one high. I may have pulled it. It may have been the gun. Doesn't matter. 5 rounds is what it ended up. And why I'm not discouraged with any of this at all is because if you guys remember, if any of you guys watched my original videos on this rifle, if you guys remember the first time I brought it out, we were shooting like 12-inch groups, 14-inch groups at 100 yards. So we're talking something that was shooting like this, barely on the paper at 100 yards, to now putting 20 within 8 inches, putting 5 within 4 or 5 inches. I don't have a tape measure with me today. I'll probably tape measure it when I get home and add those pictures in. But this is a huge improvement over what this gun originally started at. Shooting the same ammo, just surplus 147 grain, surplus spam cam ammo. I didn't change the ammo, I didn't go out and buy premium ammo to, you know, make the gun look better or whatever. I just have been using the same ammo. We went through, we cut the end of the barrel off, recrowned it. We bedded the stock. We got a scope mount mounted onto it by a gunsmith. Everything's all Loctited down and everything. All those little improvements all along the way, along with me getting better at shooting it and getting used to shooting it, have taken it from a 12-inch gun at 100 yards, or 14, whatever it was, I'll have to go back and look at the video, to now, you know, 8-inch, 6-inch, whatever this circumference is, for 20 rounds, 5 rounds within 4. So I'm really stoked with it. Happy to see the gun doing this. I mean, this is surplus ammo. If I was to go out and get a bunch of nice ammo, I'm betting I could do this all day long with nice ammo. Probably more like this one, if I don't screw up. But that's not the point of the gun. It's never was meant to be a super accuracy gun running, you know, match grade ammo. That's not even why I got the gun. I wanted a gun that I could buy surplus rounds for, super cheap, go out and shoot and have a great time, and it's still got enough knockdown power that I could use it for bear, elk, deer, whatever, if I wanted to hunt with it. So that was the main point of the rifle, and just having a cool surplus old military weapon. Whether or not this one's ever seen any action or been in anything, I don't know. But that's kind of the coolness of having one of those old milsurp weapons. It could have been. You know, it's from 1940 something. Who knows what this rifle's been through in its life and seen. So just, to me, that's just kind of cool. And it's never going to be as accurate as new rifles or precision rifles or any of that, but I wouldn't expect it to be. But I'm very pleased with how it's coming along. I like it. I like it a lot. All right, guys, hope you enjoyed.